Oh, g'day, Scrappers. Yeah, just wanted to talk about copper stackers. The copper ingots that we get out of aluminium heat sinks that are on top of motherboards out of computers. A lot of times the heat sinks can actually be just solid aluminium. Sometimes they can be solid copper. But a lot of times we get these half and half, where you've got extruded aluminium on the outside and you've got a copper ingot inside. They come in all different shapes and sizes, but they're usually these ones are the solid ones, and the first ones I showed you, they're the goblet ones. I call them goblets because they're like a little goblet. As they are, we can sell these as copper aluminium radiator. You get an okay price for them, but we can value add to these by scrapping them out, by removing the copper ingot and turning the regular aluminium into extruded aluminium. Because when you sell this as a copper aluminium radiator, they just consider it as regular aluminium and regular copper. Whereas, when we remove the aluminium, we're actually improving the value because it's actually extruded aluminium, which should be the highest price aluminium. Anyway, the way I used to do it, and if you're only doing a small amount of PCs and you only get a few of these every so often, you know, you might get one every so often. The way I used to do these is, used to go to the vise, and I'd get me heat sink and I'd put it in the vise, and then I'd get a bloody hammer and this is one of the printer rods, a nice thick one, and I would just put the rod there and I'd belt it down like that with the hammer. But a lot of times the copper can be really stuck in there, really tight, and so you end up smashing it, and sometimes they don't come out, and it's a lot of work to do. So another way I decided to do it was just by using a cutter. A lot of people might use a angle grinder or a sawzall or whatever they call them. I've got something like that. So I just pop them into the vise, tighten them up, and all I want to do is just cut the ring of the copper, of the aluminium. So all I want to do is just cut through this thick part, and then we should be able to separate it and get the copper out. So I use one of these, sort of like an angle grinder, sawzall kind of thing. It's got a round blade. You can use anything you like, angle grinder, the flat ones. So all I do is just to get into the round thing, I just open up the fins a little bit. Right, you've probably already seen that. Get myself some glasses. Okay, so I'm just going to cut through this little piece of aluminium here so we can open it up and get that copper, yeah? Okay. So it's only a little cut, and as you see, I've got a whole pile of them here, so I usually wait till I've got quite a few of them that I need to get rid of them, then I'll do them all in one go using this cutter. And so we take it out of the vise, and we can just get a screwdriver if you like. I probably cut into this a little bit too much, so we can just pop out the copper. And so now we've got straight extruded aluminium, which is like here in Australia at the moment, it's about $1.30 a kilo. So that's top grade aluminium now. And now we've got a straight candy copper. Some call it number two copper, some yards call it number one, just depending on their different grading. But it's basically candy copper. Where I cut it, as you can see, it's got a little bit of a groove, so I cut a little bit of copper off, a little bit too much. but you know, that's just how it goes. So that was a round one. We got square ones. We got these goblet ones with this is steel, so this sort of really downgrades the heatsink because of the steel. It's irony aluminium or irony copper. So in this case, when we cut this piece of aluminium, we want to cut through this steel as well to remove this steel bracket. This is the only way. These ones are very hard to pop out with these bars, but they also come out and you end up pushing out this whole steel plate. So in this case, we're just going to cut through the steel plate and get our copper out. So they're a little bit more harder to do. Just put it nice and tight. Open up at the center. Nice hole. Okay. All right, so now we've loosened off this steel plate and it's just going to come out with the copper. So now we've got our extruded aluminium, same deal. We've got our bit of steel, so we can throw this in steel. And we've got our copper stacker. Now these ones, as I said, I call them goblets because they're a little like a little drinking goblet. These are really nice. If you don't cut into them too much, they're really nice to collect. And these, what I mean by true stackers, because as you can see, they've got the solid ends. It's completely solid copper, so you can stack them up, you know, and they stack. That's why I call them stackers, because if you stack copper, you like to collect copper, this is probably the best stuff to collect, because it's solid, you get the most weight for your size. But yeah, so that's okay. Well, I've finished scrapping out these heat sinks and getting out the copper stackers. So yeah, got a nice little pile to add to the collection. Got the solid ones. Did hack into a few of them, but can't do much about it. And nice goblet stackers. They're nice too. It's all the same, it's copper, all candy copper. But these stackers here, these are really nice to stack. Some people like to stack copper as a, just like a bullion. And because they're round and they're solid little round things, they stack quite nicely. So yeah, that's why we call them copper stackers. But yeah, so that's from PC. Heat sinks that go over the CPU, you know, get into them, you can you know, scrap them out like this and you can add a little bit extra value to the heat sink rather than just selling it as a copper aluminium radiator kind of thing. You can you know, now you've got some good copper to solid copper to sell. Anyway, keep scrapping, guys, have fun, and I'll catch you next time.